And now, The Bonfire with Big J. Okerson and Dan Soder.
How bad? What you say? Now the mics are on when I yell how bad.
I was going to give one more. Calm like a bomb.
You're calm like a bomb. It's The Bonfire, Comedy Central Radio, Sirius XM 95. I'm Dan Soder. That's Big J. Okerson.
Sure as shit.
Fucking joining us right now. Yeah. Brand new special on Netflix.com.
We had a long intro. Did a long intro so we could let him get settled. Oh, there it is.
Welcome, my son. Yeah.
Go ahead, finish your intro.
Welcome to Machine. Great intro.
Oh, I love it.
If you don't have that in every, you got to have that as a drop.
It's so eerie.
I love it.
Everybody, it is The Machine. Bert Kreischer joins us in studio.
Secret Time streaming right now on Netflix. Go watch it. It's fucking hilarious.
Oh, thank you. Thank you so much. You posted something on your Insta stories.
Oh, yeah, dude. I watched it in, I was at Helium in Philly where you recorded it, and I watched it. And I was like, oh, yeah, that's at the Trop.
You did yours at the Trop.
Yeah, I did my hours. It's fucking awesome. I love that space. Dude, it looks great, man.
Can I tell you my favorite thing about my special? This is the silliest thing in the world. They wanted to do a smoke machine, but the smoke machines give me asthma. So I told them, you can't do the smoke machine. And they're like, well, wait, we've paid for a smoke machine. I go, just don't do it. And they're like, well, what will be behind you? I go, nothing, I guess. But because the place is so old, you see dust particles going up in the lights. And I got high and watched my own special with like 30 people. And all I could look at was the dust particles.
Yeah.
I was loving it.
You're like, this is badass.
This place is a relic.
There you go. There's spirits behind us. We can't use smoke machine. Wait, so if you used the smoke machine, would you be like...
I would have had an asthma attack.
Oh, man, that'd be fucking intense.
They almost plugged in. I go, what are you doing? And he's like, smoke machine. And I was like, no.
What if you didn't clear that and you're just doing your special office and you just see it creeping out under you? Like, and you're like,
you walk out, you go, I hope this is natural fog. I hope this is natural.
God, I hope there's an evil spirit behind me. It's like, it's fucking seeping in through the bottom.
The worst part is I did two shows that night. The first show fucking sucked. I sucked.
Really?
I sucked. I made a joke to my buddy Tony. You know Tony Hernandez.
Yeah.
Jax Media. I made a joke and he goes, do you ever like bomb? I go, dude, I've had sets where it's so bad where you're walking and you go to say your punchline and you step on the mic cord and the mic goes away from your mouth.
Yeah.
And that happened.
No.
That happened. I mean, it was such a bad set. It was raining. The generator went out and the crowd had to wait in the rain for an hour and a half.
So you just soaked your audience.
Soaked them. They brought them in wet. Everyone's fucking pissed. They had to kick two people out of the show. That's how bad it was.
Before it started?
During it. They were heckling during it.
What?
The first show was so bad.
What did you get heckled?
I have no idea. The guy just didn't like what
that
somebody said.
That didn't happen.
Fuck you.
They're doing fact checks on you.
Shirt back on.
That wasn't World War II. That was World War I, asshole.
My socks are wet. You suck.
I told my wife, hey, keep a notepad of like, if I flub a line so I can pick it up in the second show.
Yeah.
She walked into the green room. All my agents, my managers, and Tony, and goes, I don't even know where to start.
That's how
bad the first show was.
Really?
The Shore show was so bad that my buddy Pete Whalen, who's a professor at Penn State, texted me the next Monday, because I came home like Monday or Tuesday.
Yeah.
And he goes, I had some kids go to the first show. Let's pray to God your second show was good.
Jesus.
Like, it was that bad.
Can I ask you something? As someone that knows that theater, those steps up to the green room are very long and scary. Dude. So after that first show, were you like, what the fuck? It's like you're climbing a side of a mountain.
So first show.
You came up and when you came to, you and Christine came to the dressing room.
Yeah.
They're fucking steep as shit.
First show mistake I made is when you walk out those steps. So for everyone understanding, the steps to where the green room and where everything is are like, they're like 30 steps and they're really steep, but they're still like 20 yards behind the stage.
Yeah.
But when you walk out that door, everyone in the theater sees you.
Yeah. You can just see the whole thing.
So I made the mistake on the first show of coming out and everyone saw me and they had a spotlight and the stairs and it took me a solid fucking 45 seconds to get to the stage.
Are you side reclining like fucking like a goat? Like, you know, you see on nature shows and they're like... They're like, here comes Bert Kreischer off the mountain.
Dude, this is how bad it was. Is like, I remember when I did Last Comic Standing 2, they did this thing where they go, all right, ladies and gentlemen, Bert Kreischer on the stage. And we go, hold. And when the applause stopped, you go now. And you'd walk to silence. That same thing happened on that first show. Yeah. I walked out. They're like, the machine, and I come out, and it's huge. By the time I'm halfway down the steps, the applause is dying. By the time I'm hitting the stage, it's silent. By the time I get to them, they're like, oh, here he is again.
Yeah.
How, like, the song stops playing, and you're still like, hang on, these stairs are steep. Yeah, hang on. Hang on.
You go, guy at the bottom, four or five. Four or five. Can you spot me?
I should have wore flats. Son of a bitch.
And when everything goes silent, you just hear your own breathing as you're walking. You're like,
hang on. Are you saying those little things to yourself? Getting it. Hang on.
Here we go.
Hang on. Over. That one's rickety.
Okay.
This can't be.
Hey! He's going
to
go
this
off.
Place can't be up to fire code. Philly!
Flip up now.
But the second show was perfect.
So after the second show, you're like,
I always said this because I was an athlete growing up. I always say I like pressure. I like to be put in this. I'm the guy that likes to get the ball with 2 seconds left in the game. I love that feeling. And man, I put it to the. I was like, "Wow, I just wasted a show." It was. I mean,
I thought you said the Netflix the half hour thing, and like I felt the first one was pretty whiffed. Also, so yeah. I did feel like that. Got to get the next one.
I love
for
that
sure.
feeling though.
Yeah,
I love
think
that
I operate
feeling.
Better. On
I had a cup
too.
Of coffee with Tony. We had a cup of coffee, and I just went out. And I after I told one joke, I knew I was like I just one joke. They started stomping, and I was like, "Oh, this is the show."
Yeah,
and then you just start going. I'm in the zone. It's an out of body experience. And then when I got off. I was like, I was so fucking giddy. The end of the special is my favorite is I got off and they're still chanting the machine. And Tommy had told me, he was like, he goes, if you get off and they're still chanting the machine, go back on, start the machine story, and then cut the special to black right after that. So they're all chanting it, ripping their shirt off, the machine. So I come back out and spoiler alert, don't listen if you don't want to see it.
Yeah.
Spoiler alert. I come back out and I go, when I was 22 years old, I got involved with the Russian Mafia. Here's how it happened. And we cut to black. And Tom, to the day I die, I'll love Tom for that. Because it was the perfect way to end that special.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's fucking badass. And it's great that, like, you know, you wait for the second show and you're like, fuck, if this goes bad, then what do you do? Because if that goes bad, I did the opposite thing where with the Netflix half hour, where I had so much fun on the first show unexpectedly that I started, like, riffing on the venue. I'm like, look at this fucking thing. This looks like it's in Tim Burton's Batman. And then I was like, well, this is going to be the show. I was like in it, like, this is it. Yeah. Second show, all right, I'll change some stuff.
Meanwhile, fucking Bob Trocadero is in the balcony going, this hilarious.
Bob Trocadero.
Yeah. Well, oh, that's really funny.
This was the Lotus Club in LA, so it was actually Edward Lotus watching. But they would, dude.
Bob Lotus?
Yeah, Bob Lotus.
Eddie Lotus?
Lotus pose?
Yeah. He goes, not in my club. How are you saying it looks like a governor's ball? But then Netflix came back and they're like, hey, we're not going to use that set because you made fun of the venue. And you're like, yeah. that makes no sense.
Hey, Netflix, thanks for putting me up in this shit box. Yeah. Anywho.
Vegas, you cheap fucks. Netflix, you cheap fucks.
Black Lou, are you getting booze? Are you getting booze right now?
I'm not, but I always can.
Oh, someone would love a cocktail.
Yeah.
I've been firing hot all fucking day.
I heard people, yeah.
Do you know how hard it is to talk to your publicist and get booked on this show?
Yeah.
I literally was like, hey, just want to make sure I'm not double booked. And by the way, I'm fucking coming back from Brooklyn going like, hey, can I just do the show? Do I need to be booked or? Oh, my God.
Wait, really?
Because I reached out to my publicist because you got to send everything through them because it's like that's what they're getting hired for, I guess.
Yeah. They kind of oversee all
this. And nothing was happening. And I was like, I'm texting Jay. I'm like, I was kind of hoping that we'd do the show, maybe grab something to eat, maybe go down, something like that. What are you guys thinking?
Dude. There was something. Like Christine got something from the bookers today or something that was like, so Burke can do this. Like, I'm texting with him.
This is what happened is the publicist booked you on our show through the SiriusXM booker Roland for next week. I just explained to her, I was like, we love Bert. He is an open door. I just don't want to conflict with any other press he's doing. So it's all clear. But, you know, whenever you want to come on.
I thank you.
It's a game of telephone.
I love this. This is my favorite show to do.
What theater? Yeah, you know, when you're in town, you're just on the show.
Yeah, thank you.
Promotion or not. But what's fun is, like, it's funny when you have friends with shows and you're like, hey, I want to do your show. Like, Nate before has been like, I'm going to be in town. You're like, you just show up at 6 and I'll see you downstairs and we'll go. You know everyone. Like, that's what's crazy where it's like a publicist gets involved and they try to act professional. They're like, let me reach out to who their booker is. You're like, you just show up at Sirius and we're walking in and we'll hang out.
Oh, dude, this has been aggressive. This run, I've never been like this in my career where you get like the publicist.
Yeah.
I got like a makeup lady to come with me places. Dude, it was so uncomfortable. I did Theo's podcast, And my publicist and my makeup lady came with me. And I was like, guys, I'm just going into this room with Theo. You need to stay outside. Cheers. This is really bad.
I love a
That's
fucking...
That's really great.
Just, I love
all
an
right, are you guys on a break right now? I'm going to come in here and just you're shining a little bit.
You guys, guys, this is Karen. She actually, fun thing, she worked on all the Lethal Weapons. She's just fucking blotting you. You
sound like that. Danny Glover is a nightmare.
She goes, I'll tell you this, Joe Pesci, an angel. Guy never forgets where he comes from.
Mel Gibson, anti-Semitic as he may be.
Yeah.
Bro. A mensch.
Mel Gibson has legit. Can you believe the, are we talking about the Louis thing yet?
That he went back on stage?
Yeah. Were you there? I want to know what he said.
Yeah, I wasn't there.
I wasn't there, but I was at the Cellar last night and talked to Mo Amir, who said he was there, and he said Louis went on stage and, you know, said,
pulled his dick out and made
just
everybody
said,
watch
look at it! Look at it!
You
it's
see
hard!
It?
It's bull!
I want to see some action out there! I want to see some action out there! Yeah. I'm in fucking purgatory! You know, the day destroys the night. Night divides the day.
Goes, yeah, Louis went on stage and did a full Jim Morrison Miami meltdown.
He did more in 69.
Yeah, did you see that he did a Jim Morrison meltdown?
He's just like,
the Dade County cops came and got
us. It's the Miami's 1969.
Jay showed me the scene literally fucking 2 hours ago. We were watching
I told him my new favorite thing in the world. I go, I want to hear Dan's impression. Michelle Wolf does Morrison, Miami 69.
She goes,
you're all slaves. You're all a bunch of fucking slaves. You're all slaves. You want to see some action? You want to see it? You want to see it? No rules.
Did Michelle melt down in Miami?
I'm going to get my kicks for the whole shit down first.
Everyone's fucking. You want to see some action?
I'm talking about love. Love. Love.
Yeah.
Love. You want to fuck? Fuck. Oh, yeah.
Bring up the Morrison speech.
Oh, that's great.
It's great. Damn, following along doing it.
Are they, I mean, they're making this like a real big story that he came back and did a set, huh?
Dude, Michael Ian Black got fucking lit up today because all he said was, I think there should be a path to redemption.
Yeah.
That's all he said. Really? I mean, I don't know. I didn't read all of his tweets. But I like Michael Ian Black. He's a friend of mine.
He goes, girls need to watch. You go, Bert, you should have read a little bit ahead.
Dude, I did an interview today.
Yeah.
And I, you know, when that shit happened with that, I don't know what we can't, I'm assuming we can talk about everything, but
yeah,
when the Legion of Skanks had that Proud Boy thing go down.
Yeah.
And everyone was boycotting the Creek.
Yeah.
I got defensive of the Creek. So I like that place and I like Rebecca. And, right?
Yeah,
and,
she's awesome.
Yeah. And I was like, yeah. And I did this thing on my other, I have two podcasts. I do my regular podcast with everyone, and then I do one called Open Tabs. And I had open tabbed a bunch of Proud Boy fights. And I went on Slate. I went on like a liberal podcast today, and they're like, so are you like, what's up with the Proud Boys? And I was like, I don't know. Like, I'm such a fucking idiot.
Yeah.
But I had, like, Googled all these Proud Boy fights versus Antifa.
Yeah.
And just been commentating on them. And then they were like, are you a Proud Boy? Are your fans Proud Boys? And I was like, I don't know. What am I saying? And I just fucking shut the fuck up.
Like, maybe some.
Yeah.
I mean, like,
well, it's so confusing to be like,
it's such a small faction of the world, number one.
But it's also a thing. Group. It's like, I don't think you're outwardly marketing towards that.
Yeah.
And not only
but what he said was,
Ladies and gentlemen, Proud Boys. I'd like to tell you a story.
Yeah.
This guy was actually a really good interviewer. I forget his name. It was on The Gist. He's a really good interviewer. And the thing was, I hadn't really done any research on anything. I just started watching videos, and there's this one guy, Tiny, that's a Proud Boy. I think he's like Samoan.
Yeah.
And he just lights motherfuckers up.
Well, that's what's so funny about us is like, we just want to watch internet fights.
Yeah.
And then there's like a political message behind it. You go, oh, dude, I was just watching like some Kimbo Slice shit. Like if they told you like, you know, Kimbo Slice is a black Israelite.
Yeah.
Like, he doesn't like when people be like, oh no, he just wears a cool chain and fucking knocks motherfuckers through fences.
They started macing him and he opened his fucking mouth up. He didn't give a shit.
Yeah. You know? Like,
oh, is this Tiny?
Wait, so it's not white pride. His version of Proud Boy is not white pride.
I don't know. You know what?
I'm
the wrong person to talk about any of this. And I said this on this podcast today. I don't know anything about anything.
Yeah.
I mean, All I know is that I had these two Proud Boys come to one of my show, and they gave me a Proud Boy coin.
Yeah.
And I was like, oh, it's badass. And then my dad saw it and was like, are you a fucking Proud Boy? And I was like, what? And he was, and then my dad got really pissed. He's like, get rid of that fucking coin.
Yeah.
You can't have that. Like, that's like having like a clan thing, but it just looked, it's like a, it's a challenge coin.
Yeah.
It looked cool as fuck.
Here's the thing. It probably was cool.
It's like when Lemmy, it's like when Lemmy bought like the, you know, like when Lemmy was into like war artifacts or whatever. And they're like, are you a Nazi? And he's like, I just got a lot of Nazi things.
Is
like,
this the guy from, is this guy?
Yeah. Mike Pesca.
He's really a great guy and he's a great interviewer and you should have him on the show,
but like,
he's smart as fuck.
So this is the podcast that you did. Today, where he brought up the fact that you
watched. But he wasn't being a dick.
Yeah. No, I got you. But I think the Proud Boys thing, the best way I can probably explain it is, I guess there's people involved in that that have perverted it to be like a white supremacist thing, but there's so many not white Proud Boy guys.
Now, that's what he's,
that the whole thing, to me, to join a group, there's an initiation for it. It's just such like the queefiest thing I could think of.
Yeah.
So I'm not like, I'm whatever about it, but if that's what you want to do, go for it. Their belief is that, their whole thing is based off of Western chauvinism. So it's that the woman, not that a woman's a piece of shit and should only be cooking and cleaning and taking care of babies. They're like, that's the awesome thing that women are able to do and take care and raise a family, and a man goes out and works. Now, I don't subscribe to any of what they're saying.
Yeah.
But that's the ultimate thing of what these, like what they like to go out there and bark about. Now, if there's a racist thing to it, I think that would just sort of like being like saying like all Yankees fans are racist, and you go, yeah, he goes, you're going to say there's no white supremacists that are Yankees fans? Like, yeah, probably there are, but you can't just say that all Yankees fans are racist.
It's got to be a weird place to be, though, like a white supremacist of, and you're a fan of the Yankees, and they're just bringing in Dominican sluggers, and you're like, I am so enraged, but this guy drops balls.
If you're not, if you're not a racist, if you're not a racist Proud Boy, or a white supremacist Proud Boy, I don't know.
I'm talking about.
It must be really worth it to be in the Proud Boys for something that you would sit through people constantly coming down that group. Like, why would you just be like, if they came to me and go, if you don't denounce the Proud Boys, you're a racist, I'll go, I denounce the Proud Boys.
Yeah.
Like, who gives a shit?
I was thinking of how much harder it is to be a racist sports fan, because then your ideologies clash almost immediately, where you're like, these stupid blacks, God, that guy can just fucking go, can he?
But when they lose, it gives you a good excuse. To go, I knew it.
Yeah.
I don't know why I'd trust him to win it.
Yeah.
Dude, there's an old clip. I was laying in bed. My daughter came in bed and got in bed with me early in the morning. Sometimes I listen to podcasts or I listen to old ONA, right?
Yeah.
There's a clip about Patrice O'Neill, how he says that Asians are, I think, basically animals. And, and he's not, like, this is way before you could have gotten in trouble with this.
He's very racist about Asians.
It was so racist. It was not even like undertones. You know what I'm talking about, right?
I know exactly what you're talking
about.
And it's
like, he's like, they suck. I fucking hate them. And I'm listening because it's Patrice, and my daughter's hearing it. I think she's asleep. She's like, Dad, who is this guy?
You go, oh, man. That's like if you put on Pryor's Live and Smoking, and someone walks in, and he goes like, oh, yeah, you know, you suck too many dicks, you get addicted to that shit. And you go, who's this? You go, this is the greatest comedian of all time.
Eddie Murphy.
Yeah.
Eddie Murphy, the beginning of Raw.
Oh, dude, it's... Yeah, where he's talking about Raw, when he's talking about coming to San Francisco.
No, he goes,
actual fag on the car, go, woo, pull over.
You haven't seen it in a while.
Oh, yeah, you're
the
right.
The first 15 seconds of Eddie Murphy, the first one, the woman who's in the red outfit.
Oh, it's delirious.
It's delirious. Yeah. He keeps
trying. I gotta move around because faggots be looking at my ass.
Yeah.
You're like, and he goes, what?
You start having dreams that everybody, yeah.
That was my big gripe within the comic strip up here in New York. Like,
that was it.
I was banned from working there because I made sure William Stevenson didn't get beat up for calling a woman a cunt.
Yeah.
And then they told me I was like a piece of shit for trying to help him and make sure the club didn't get sued.
That was right when the show started.
Yeah, and then when their whole argument about...
Oh, is this it?
It was their big argument about that word and that word cunt.
I call Chelsea Handler a cunt in my special.
Yeah, and then I go...
I like her, I like her. I have a crush on her, kinda.
And you're not on Netflix anymore.
And her dog's name's Bert. And so every time I have hear her in her Instagram stories, go, Bert, get in bed with me. And I'm like...
Yeah, okay.
But I pointed out that the Richie Tinkin, the owner of the comic strip...
Yeah?
It was also Eddie Murphy's, like, he's like walking him in that video to the stage. Richie Tinkin and all both of his specials, and they have the albums on the wall, like the gold albums. And I was like, "Well, you're worried about the word cunt." He goes, "Both of those albums. There's three tracks total that say the word faggots on printed on like the disc."
Yeah,
and it's like, you know, it's
It's Faggots and Faggots Revisited.
Yep.
Faggots Revisited might be the greatest title. I know.
When I tell the story, that's why I say Faggots Revisited.
Yeah, he goes, okay. Well, there's also Chink and then Return to Chinkland, where you're like, I don't even think.
Faggots Revisited is on the next album.
Faggots Revisited is more of a concept album.
Justin, in doing stand-up, you would never do one chunk and then do it again later. Like, do another.
A Revisited?
Guys, forgot to mention this about Faggots.
Guys, I got dating's weird Revisited.
Guys, I hate to jump back into the Faggots thing, but did you guys know they fuck each other's mouths too?
He goes, ew.
I thought it was all butt shit, but I got 15 more minutes of mouth stuff.
Guys, I'm looking
can you imagine getting dude pubes in your teeth, man? Yes,
I'm looking at a whole different angle on this dick on dick sex, and I need to revisit it. I mean, heavily revisit. Play the beginning, because you had it up. Mm-hmm. I mean, what is it, 22
years old?
Jeez,
Pete Davidson right here.
Oh, hey, everybody.
2 years younger right now.
Yeah.
Pete Davidson is 24.
Oh, wow. Look at this. This is straight up rock star shit. Yeah. Oh, my God. He's got a velvet stage.
When I feel the heat on my ass,
preacher,
I switch it.
Dude, I lack so much confidence that I'd have to go right out to the mic and just be like, hi, I'm talking. Please like me. Reinforce that you like me. He's just like walking around like, huh?
I actually consciously didn't do what he did on my special because I've seen.
Wear leather, all leather?
Yeah.
Hey, you.
Oh, he's thank got the fucking much. Belt pegged.
Too kind, far too kind. Before I even get started, I want to say, how about a big round of applause for the bus boys?
Bus boys out there clearing pre.
Have you ever heard Charlie Murphy's Bus Boys story?
About the band?
No, about the jacket?
No.
Put a pin in that. That's the best story ever told. Best story ever told. Keep going. Let's hear him.
Get some rules. I got some rules when I throw down. When I do my stand-up, I got rules and shit.
Oh, wow.
Straight up. Faggots aren't allowed to look at my ass while I'm on stage.
Yeah. I mean, just coming out the gates. Dude, just coming out the gates, you're going like, woof.
That's why I keep moving while I'm up here.
If you drop that in an arena now, if you walked out and said that, everyone would be like, what's up? What?
Luke, can you make it a drop, though?
Yeah.
Well, I got one rule. Faggots can't be looking at my ass when I'm up here. I want that to play.
And then crickets?
Yeah.
Or a smattering of applause.
It's just a bunch of like sad, like, oh. Yeah.
Can you show all Eddie Murphy clips, but with the audience reaction of Hannah Gadsby's Nanette?
Yeah.
That's one of the funniest things.
Just flip it. Give her all the delirious pops.
Oh.
Yeah, that clap.
Do you have any of our Hannah Gadsby Def Jam?
I'd have to look for it.
Just gonna give Bert a little
22 years
I've
old.
I've seen it. Are you kidding me? I was one of my favorite things I've ever seen.
Faggots Revisited.
Yeah.
Jesus.
Faggots Revisited.
We've been waiting for a long time.
Sexual Prime. That looks, you're like, hey, are you gay? If your first track's called Faggots Revisited, Sexual, what was it?
Y'all thought I was done. Crime. There's all kinds of freaky deaky fag shit you can talk about.
I gotta come back because, yo, they look so beautiful when they do it. Like a guy that keeps talking about it because he clearly wants to do it.
Nah, I know I talked about this last time.
You ever
see these faggots now on crazy acting?
You ever smelled it? He goes, smells good. What?
Yeah. Butt fucks smell better than y'all think.
Mm-hmm. He goes, butt fuck ain't that bad. It's kind of pleasant. Like, Eddie, I feel like you're bringing it up all the time, like you might be gay. He goes,
this crazy
what?
Faggot come tell me you got to breathe into it. So I breathe into it. Yeah. And it went in. Goes, it went in.
You ever had a pop?
Ooh.
Wait, did you say anything? He goes, no, I'm doing an impression of a gay guy. I don't think you are. I think you're gay. That is the funny thing. Like when people keep bringing up the same thing, where you're like, hey, do you really just want to talk about this or what's going on?
Especially with Eddie Murphy, too. It's like every, you know, he couldn't dress gayer technically.
Technically.
I mean, he's missing a mesh tank top for sure, but that's it.
Can you imagine how much the bus boys must have hated hip hop?
Oh, yeah.
This is what they were doing.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, George Thorogood music?
Yeah.
Downtown. They're doing steps.
Yeah.
Coming out.
By the way, it's not even the best black guy Boys Are Back in Town song.
No.
Thin Lizzy.
Yeah.
Boys Are Back. Way better.
Way better.
But it's so funny that they're like, guys, I see a 20, 30 year career out of this kind of music. And then hip hop comes along.
I feel like this is a band that.
Fuck. Fuck. Fuck.
Oh, yeah. I feel like this is like a band that would like play at like my summer camp when I was younger.
Oh, are you kidding me? I bet we could book him for a wedding.
But you've never heard Charlie Murphy's Busboy Jacket story?
Oh, no, please.
Hey, can you pull up? it's just type in Bert Charlie Murphy. Bert Charlie Murphy, it's got to come up. I think I edited it.
Oh, it's YouTube.
I edited it so people could see it. It's on my YouTube, I think, maybe. Charlie Murphy Busboy. It's my it's the reason. It's what inspires me to do stand-up.
Really?
No joke. This story is so good because it's like, I like, you know how I like a story that's just soft. It doesn't need to kill you. Doesn't need to murder you. It just is like a story. You listen and then you go, it's such a good story. And it's just, I think we've all been there. By the way, I'm now overweight explaining it. Yeah. Are we getting booze? All right, let's, I put it on my Facebook.
Tell me what to type in one more time.
I think you just had it.
Is on Facebook?
I think it's on my Facebook. Bert, Charlie Murphy.
Should we take our first break while she tries to find them?
Yeah, that's fine. We're going to take our first break. The machine.
We're hanging out.
Bert Kreischer hanging out.
We're getting some booze.
Also, when we come back at some point, I saw a thing on Facebook today that said how to name your Netflix special.
That's it. Yeah. How to name your Netflix special?
Yeah, there's a formula. You know, like the porn formula was your first pet and the block you grew up on. The Netflix special is, I don't want to say it yet because I want us to all do it fresh.
Good cliffhanger.
Dun, dun, dun.
Whitney come in and said, you should have called yours Belly Laughs.
No,
I was like, bad. Fuck, it would have been good.
Secret Time's great.
Secret Time is great.
Some guy hit me on the hashtag Secret Time today. He goes, Secret Time, when I was a kid, one time, I was so excited, I jacked off and tasted my own cum. I was like, that's what I'm looking for.
You go, hashtag Super Secret Time. Hashtag hold that one onto yourself, bud. You're tasting your own product? That's fucking crazy. Dude, you never get high in your own supply.
He goes, I've had to cut back on salt since.
And he goes, let me tell you this, now I just snowball myself. I just come to my own hand and blast it.
We'll come back. We have the story too. Don't forget, we have that story of the kid that freaks out when his mom or something catches him jacking it.
Oh yeah, the jacking video, the beat the meat.
Yeah,
it's great.
We'll be right back. We're hanging out with the machine. You're 40 years old. You have high blood pressure. Walk that fucking bike home. It's one of the best stories ever told on this show. Bert Kreischer joins us. The machine.
That story's never made it to stage. It'll never be as good as that one moment we shared it.
It was so
unbelievable.
Great.
I'm coughing.
Bonfire, Comedy Central Radio, Sirius XM 95, Big Jokerson, Dan Soder.
How you doing?
Hanging out with Bert Kreischer, his new special, Secret Time, streaming right now on Netflix.
One of my new favorite
Real quick before we jump into naming our Netflix specials, because this was, I did it for myself, and it was actually kind of weirdly fun.
Really? It kind of works? I was going to say, off Secret Time, Bert gave me a new favorite term, hint of cunt.
That's my wife.
Dude, I love it because you were nailed it. You're like, yeah, every guy wants that little, you want a little grating edge where you're kind of like, all right, motherfucker.
Mark Norman gave me the line, he goes, because I was running it with Mark at the Wilbur with my wife.
Yeah.
And I said, yeah, man, when I was just riffing, I didn't know the bit, but I go, it's like my wife, like you can definitely summon the cunt, like if you just talk down to her and you're a man.
Mm-hmm.
And he goes, you know, Mark, well, unlike any man, you just got to say it once.
Yeah.
And I put the line right in.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Got a perfect line, you fatty.
Mark my cock.
Yeah. Dude, a torso on that kid. I learned that at Bonnaroo. He stripped his shirt off.
He's got a nice body on him.
He's got a great body. I want to get back to there.
Yeah, you want to get Mark Norman's skateboarder body?
I want to be like Kevin Smith. Is that your real head kind of body?
Oh, yeah.
Kevin Smith has lost so much fucking weight.
Has he?
Dude, he looks amazing.
I haven't seen a picture of Kevin Smith in a while.
Yeah,
he had
a heart attack, right?
Yeah, he had a heart attack right after he did a show.
Todd Glass, man. Todd Glass lost a ton of weight and stayed in great shape.
Todd Glass has always been in shape, right?
No, he was heavy. He had a heart attack.
You thinking of Ian Bag?
No,
Todd Glass.
For real? Yeah, like, look at Kevin Smith.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, Kevin Smith looks great.
That's so weird.
Wait, can I show you the picture that...
It's weird that he dresses like that, though, still. Because now it looks like almost like a big thing. Were you a child yesterday? And now you're a grown adult?
Yeah, but he dress like a kid still.
When you don't know somebody one way, though... You start to realize their face somehow looks better, like heavier though.
Yeah, yeah. There's people that have that changed for
that.
The positive.
My face, like, I think my face looks very different, even like now from when I did heavier, and like not that it doesn't look better, but it just looks.
You got good high cheekbones.
Thank you, Dave.
Dude, I'll tell you this right now. You're effable as hell.
Thanks, bro.
Effable?
Effable. He's so
did you see? Did you see the picture of Ben Affleck going to rehab?
No.
I did, yeah.
Dude. Oh, Ben, is it puffy face?
No, it just... Oh, man. I connected because my wife is Jennifer Garner.
Oh, she's...
Like, my wife is that woman. No, go to... See if you get Jack in the Box, Jennifer Garner, Ben Affleck. Dude, I looked at that and I went... I'll be there one day.
Just
my wife and her friend Sandy up front, and they're getting me in and out. I'm not going to get a fucking Jack in the Box.
Yeah, come on.
Look at him. Look at him. She's got her head down, and she's like, Ben Affleck, just eat this.
Yeah, here. I keep thinking you're saying...
What is it?
I keep thinking you're saying Bella Fleck.
Yeah. Bella Fleck. I am saying Bella Fleck.
Yeah, Ben Affleck.
Ben Affleck. Ben Affleck. Yeah, Ben Affleck.
But Bella Fleck is the fucking... isn't that like a banjo player?
Yeah, he plays with Dave Matthews.
Yeah.
I was a fan of his first.
Yeah. I'm a bigger Bella Fleck than Ben Affleck.
I don't want to get too far away because I know he's on the phone here. We have somebody waiting on our phone here, so I don't want to run him so we could... Go back to talking about whatever the fuck we want.
Back to just playtime.
It's playtime. That's what the show is. But we have somebody, I don't want to leave him on hold here. The campers have done a pretty cool thing and organized with Black Lou.
Yeah.
A
Lewis Johnson
campers
took over the
fantasy football. Campers Fantasy Football League.
The fall of 2018 saw Lewis Johnson attain power he would not soon lose. The Raiders of Oakland came to Minnesota with one goal in mind, to score the Gary's fantasy football team the most points possible. Well, the dude's on the phone, right?
He is indeed. Howard Bender we have. Howard Bender from Fantasy Alarm with Howard Bender and Jim Bowden. Weekdays 4 to 6 Eastern on Sirius XM Fantasy Sports Radio. Sirius 210 XM 87. Howard, are you there, my friend?
Yeah, guys, I got to tell you, I am. I was perfectly fine hanging out and listening because I've got a bunch of fantasy football team names now, like Proud Boy Jews and Devontae Parker's a faggot cunt. I mean, I'm like psyched right now.
Oh, wow. Those are some of the team names coming through?
Yeah, I'm actually renaming all my fantasy football team names this, right?
Oh, wow, you're getting aggressive. What an aggressive fantasy football, man.
Throw it down.
I'd almost be like, I don't really know if I want to take part in fun fantasy football with a team that aggressive.
Now, because leading the league is learn the language or get the fuck out of the country.
Yeah.
Not in my backyard.
Cum suckers are up 56 to 17.
Yeah. Come suckers.
Yeah.
God hates fags and the Seahawks.
God hates fags and the Seahawks.
I mean, for this guy's league, that actually might be perfect.
It's very, very possible. The Proud Boy Jews is hilarious. They got their own faction now. What we have going on here, Howard, is we're about to pick the draft order of the campers. The campers, our listeners, Fantasy Football League. But Bert, in your special, at the end of it, it says special thanks. Second thing says the campers. That can't be.
No.
That can't be.
That's you guys.
It's the fan. You're saying that.
You liar. I know.
No, it's where I got.
Bert, look at me.
It's all the fans of the bonfire.
Let me tell you right now. I'm a Bert Kreischer fan, but don't lie to me.
This is going
to
hurt me.
You know what it is? It's his. It's so funny because there was a moment. The only reason I bring this up is there was a moment where I was like, that's so awesome.
Me too. And then someone tweeted at me.
And I go like this.
Cool. And they meant it. The camper who tweeted it out meant it. Was like, how cool is that? Like, Bert like loves the fans so much. And I went...
As someone that listens to his podcast, I know that that's what his wife and their friends call their group. So I know that from listening to his podcast.
Because part of it's like he did it in Philly. Dude, maybe there was a lot of fans.
Crackle.
Yeah, let me tell you exactly what it was. When my dad lived in San Francisco, he worked at a liquor store named Dan's Liquors. And I thought he worked there because it was my name. And it was just because he was an alcoholic and I wanted to work at a liquor store. But I was like, Dan's Liquors, yeah, Dad. Oh, shit. Same feeling when I was like, the camp. Oh, God, that's not meant for us at all.
Well, we have a... We have four of the campers here that have put in a bunch of team names.
Yeah.
And we're here to pick our top three. Kombucha.
Oh.
What the hell's that for?
Did you go opposite direction, Jacob?
Yeah, you kombucha and kale. Yeah.
What if you just... Oh, is that a brand new one?
Yeah.
Oh, nice. I always call my fantasy football team Sparkle Motion.
Sparkle Motion?
Yeah.
Okay.
I'm highly questioning your commitment to Sparkle Motion.
Yeah.
Jacob, from Donnie Darko.
We need like ice and cups and blah,
and
blah,
soda
blah.
Water and whatever.
Soda water and whatever. He's right.
Jacob was definitely right now walking down the hallway going, I didn't fucking...
Working radio for fucking 20 years to be a goddamn waiter.
Be you. Fucking cool. 4 years. Still paying off those goddamn debts. I'll never get a debt.
You doped up clowns fall ass backward into a goddamn radio show. I gotta be a fucking waiter.
Fall ass backwards into a radio show.
That's what the fuck I gotta do. I'm a goddamn broadcaster. You fucking idiots.
Hope you guys find yourself on the ass end of a World Star Hip Hop video.
Yeah. He goes, oh, I'd love it. I'd love it. He goes, oh, God, please, why can't an Uber driver just snap and murder these two fucks?
Fucking pussy.
Whoa, Jacob.
Hope you fucking choke on your goddamn munchkins.
Yeah.
Fucking faggot.
I'm Howard, so here.
Jesus, Jacob gets pretty angry.
Public apology is going to be coming from him soon.
Yeah.
Howard, we have our top three picked out already, and we are to announce those now.
Yes,
we with the first...
Before the show, I had you guys look at all the team names and pick the top three that you thought were the most funny.
Mm-hmm.
So we have number one picking Hee Hee What Childhood.
Hee Hee dot 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 What Childhood, as we all know, is a reference
to the Fell Dog.
Fell Dog. Corey Feldman.
What Childhood? Oh, yeah.
That's like one of our favorite drops.
Yeah. By the way, Corey Feldman has you know, he has a new secret group.
Dude, we need to do...
Do we look into that? The Truthers yet? The Corey Feldman, Feldog Truthers?
Can I just... I mean, I'm so happy Bert's here that we can get into a new chapter of Corey Feldman with him.
Oh, yeah.
I think 7 o'clock hour...
Did you watch?
I didn't watch it, but that almost makes it better for Bert and I because you can explain it and we can go through it.
All right. Yeah, I think you should see it.
All right.
But I'll talk about it. I'll tell you about it for sure. For goddamn sure.
Corbin Nash?
Buddy.
Corbin Nash.
Is that the name
of it? It's on Netflix right now. It's Corey Feldman's newest movie where he plays a tranny vampire. And for the first half of the movie, he's committed to like a Buffalo Bill voice. Is that what his name is?
My
Buffalo
voice? Bill?
Yeah, but no, but the real, he's doing like, and he says, he goes, I want to fuck me. Everybody wants to fuck me. And he's doing that, and then by the end of the movie, he's just, hey. He's back to Corey Feldman
guys,
voice.
Guys, I didn't know it was going to be a 3-week shoot.
He goes, that's me in every audition.
Can you guys remind me what the voice was? I kind of made a bold decision day one.
I got stabbed by the wolf pack.
I had no idea the dude was still alive.
What Childhood.
Great.
Picking number one in the draft, everyone. There's high fives happening right now.
All over the organizations.
Fucking Pat Croce's fucking high-fiving other team's owners. Number two, Lou?
Not Built for Sex Island. Number two.
Not Built for Sex Island.
We wanted to send Jacob to Sex Island, which was a place that you could spend money.
No, I think that was Lou.
No, Jacob goes, I'm not built for Sex Island.
It was Jacob. I thought it was a Lou drop.
This is when Lou had a girlfriend. So this is Jacob. I'm not built for Sex Island. Sex Island experience. This is what we're going to send Jacob to.
I think it ended up getting canceled, right?
Yeah, it ended up being just a bunch of prostitutes.
As soon as they made a viral video, it got canceled.
Yeah, they made like a fucking huge like a hype video for it, and then the government was like, we're going to look into this.
It's basically it's a Miami yacht party with 50 hookers on it, but they advertised the world like, come on, like you. Dude who fucking drives a forklift. If you come up with $6,000, you can fuck all these shit. Then you get there, and then you're on the high seas with some fucking Bolivian chick with a fucking razor blade under her tongue. You're just going to fucking...
I cannot shut eyes when we do it. Oh, this is the commercial.
Yeah.
Free alcohol.
Yeah.
Jacob.
This could all be yours.
Oh, man, it was raining bitches that weekend. I literally couldn't stop fucking...
Surprises. I'd see that and I'd be like, guys, it's too much. What are we doing here?
Thought I had gonorrhea. Realized I was just spending too much time in a saltwater pool.
Wait, this isn't a reality show?
No.
Private island. It's cold. Yeah.
Performing. Ja Rule.
How many people do you think got to the island and were like, whoo, not who I thought would be here?
Oh, my God.
Oh, no.
Yeesh. Wow,
you
Mom.
Do not look like the pamphlet.
Why is that? Why does that woman have a t-shirt tan?
Yeah. Oh, wow. Yeah, because we're like in the masks and bikinis. You're like, all right. And then you're like, she turns out she's 6'2". And a pretty mean 6'2".
I'm not built for Sex Island. Picking number two. Jacob, you still have a chance. Number three.
Number three is Snow Bunnies and Wood Boogers.
Snow Bunnies and Wood Boogers.
Yeah.
That's racist Clint Eastwood.
That was the funniest thing. Yes, that's racist Clint Eastwood terms for white women and black dudes. And that, of course...
Let's pick a number three.
We say that is, in fact, you?
That is me.
That's Black Lou.
The commish.
The commish himself picking three.
Getting third, and I didn't know that. We didn't know that.
We didn't know either.
So the four, who's the fourth team?
So what we're going to do real quick is just do a rapid fire, pick everything in succession.
Thank you.
But real quick, Howard, can you tell me who I should pick at number three, who's going at number three right now at the ADP?
Well, you got to hope that Todd Gurley goes number one, Lev Bell goes number two, which means at number three you got David Johnson. And why wouldn't you want David Johnson?
Because I'd want Jimmy Garoppolo.
Because you know Carson Wentz is out there.
You know, I heard that. I heard we had a Niners fan and an Eagles fan here, immediately, like, the Jimmy Grapes reference. I get it. He's so handsome.
Right. It doesn't mean he can do anything with a football, but Jimmy Carson Wentz is odd looking. That's why that guy knows how to fucking toss a cannon.
Yeah, unfortunately, that cannon's not going to fire off until, like, week three or four.
Yeah. So,
a lot of people are saying that.
Well, I'll also let you know that Jimmy G will be taking off his helmet as soon as week one. So you're welcome, world.
He's having, now, what's the inside word on that, the Carson Wentz thing? Why do you say that?
The reports that came out today, Doug Peterson getting all aggro, answering the same question over and over again. Wentz himself said he came out today and he said there was a statistic that he saw that guys who come back from this particular surgery ahead of the 9-month schedule have a greater chance of suffering the re-injury again.
What a dork.
So he's kind of pulling himself out of the race here a little.
Wow.
He doesn't care about you, Jay.
I don't trust anyone with that many freckles on their goddamn face. I said it from the beginning. Listen. I don't like freckles.
I'm sorry. I'm over in San Francisco with a hot-ass quarterback.
That's all right. I'm going to spend $17,000 for tickets to go watch Nick Foles.
I got Jared Goff.
You got Jared Goff. Oh, yeah, you're a Rams fan.
Oh, yeah.
I'm going to Rams at Niners. You should come, you should come up.
Yeah.
Why aren't you a Dolphins fan?
I would have been a Bucs fan. I'm a Bucs fan, technically.
Of Tampa.
But because we got season tickets all on my daughters and my wife. And my wife just made a call. She's like, we're new Rams fans. And so the whole family just became Rams fans. It was really fun.
And they're local. That's fun.
Yeah. We have season tickets. It's a blast.
Yeah, that's
badass. Ari's there. Renazizi's there. It's great.
You guys are going to lose twice to the Niners, but, you know, it's fine.
I think I'm going to bet $100 on the Rams every fucking game.
Really?
Yeah.
It's real throw caution to the window.
Where it starts. But
You go, next, my kids lost their college fund. We got to fill the pool back up, put grass over it.
I get to own being a Rams fan because it was scary when they first got there and all the fucking cholos were show up in Raiders jerseys and go, how long you been a Rams fan, huh?
Yeah.
Bro? Whoa, big Rams fan, huh?
Those are I like that the Niners are more choloed out now.
We went to see the Chargers Eagles out in L.A. and it's just an Eagles home game, really, at that point.
Well, Rams-Eagles was an Eagles home game.
Yeah.
Well, until the Rams decide to put a helmet across the knee of Carson Wentz, and apparently, according to my new friend Howard, that likes delivering bad news upon his first meeting, okay.
What do you have in that bag?
This is going to be the rest of the names of the teams. We have to pick them so they can find their order in the draft. I will go first. I'm going to shuffle these around. And the next team picking in the draft, Old Airwolf. The team Old
Airwolf.
Remember
the show Airwolf?
The name?
Yeah, of course.
Jacob was obsessed with it when it was on.
Really?
Jacob, go ahead. Give him a pick.
Did you like Murphy Brown and Providence, too?
I love Murphy Brown. Murphy Brown's the shit's coming back. Hey, everybody, good news.
Yeah, without Elvin.
Hey, he's dead. Get over it, Jay.
Yeah, read it.
Team Lariat.
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 Pick five.
Pick five.
Now this is going to be pick five?
Six right here.
You want? Hang on.
You guys do it. Keep going. Keep rapid firing this shit.
Next, Danish Dans.
I'm not Danish at all, but I appreciate it. I like Danishes.
No, they're Danish.
Love Danishes.
They're Danishes. Oh, Danish Dan was, that was a thing. I remember. Man, we spoke pot on the show. Sometimes you really fucking forget bits.
Bill Cosby sleepers.
That's just cruel to the victims.
That's just inappropriate.
Come on,
that's
man. Louis C.K.'s back, guys. We need to start them all.
Everything's back, man. It's fine.
Cosby's back, guys. They brought the Cosby show back.
Yeah. Dress less provocatively, women. I think that's what the bonfire really stands for.
Would you watch the Cosby show if they had all the stuff going on with his trial in the every episode? So like he came home, he was like,
Claire.
And he was like, Claire. And then she's like, I think you're going to get off. And he's like, I think I'm going to jail for a long time. Like every episode was about the trial.
Yeah, Theo getting ripped apart by it at school.
Dad, I got him a fight at school.
Because how many people did you rape, Dad?
Thomas said you raped his mom.
Tootie says she doesn't want to be in the same room as you. You're a monster.
Did you say Tootie?
Oh, yeah. Tootie's fucking
facts of life.
Rudy. Fuck, I meant Rudy.
They should do one sitcom where all the black people from sitcoms meet each other.
Yeah, they all come in. They all cross over.
I thought it was a crossover in general. Tootie Joe Blair. I'd like to talk to you.
These are the facts of life. Drink as much as you can and lay down in your beds.
Let Mrs. Garrett could get it.
Yeah, Mrs.
Girls. Girls. Bill Cosby.
That was the time that I fucked the young Charlotte Ray. Wow.
When I took down Mrs. Garrett, it was like taking down a water buffalo. You got to get inside and you get in with the rape.
Rue McClanahan's working the helmet and Blanche is down there licking the ball.
All the golden girls are on my shaft.
Where does Rerun fit into all this, huh? Him, Raj, Dwayne?
And Nell?
Oh, yeah.
Dude, Nell, I was so attracted to the youngest daughter in that fucking show.
Yeah. Joey Lawrence?
Is that Joey Lawrence?
No, that was Dee.
Him too.
Dee was the daughter.
Dee.
Yeah. Just a fucking emphatic head nod. Yeah.
I like the I like the dark haired daughter from Too Close for Comfort.
Bring her up.
I liked her a lot. She was
really
Jackie. Well, the obvious was the blonde.
So
I liked the,
like the I always went for the blonde and then I ended up marrying Jackie.
Yeah. Reject Gay would be the next team, by the way. What number is that, Lou?
I think we're on 7 here.
Okay. Next, there's three more teams.
Four more teams left.
Next, we have Sean Furious, second to none.
Sean Furious, fucking definitely not second to none. We found out about Sean Fury 2 weeks ago. He's an independent artist, I believe as you can call him. He's an actor. More importantly, he's a singer.
Can you just break him off? Just break him off a little piece.
Can we get a little biracial? She's a biracial
girl. She's a biracial.
Oh.
Yeah. Biracial.
It's all right.
Girl.
If you're hard, it's okay. You're not judged here. Sean Fury is biracial. Second to none.
If you want to actually, Christine, with no sound, if you want to throw up one of his music videos, you know, maybe pick that one.
Oh, God. He won't rape again.
No, not this one.
He won't rape again?
Yeah.
He won't rape again?
No, no. She said no.
She said no, no, no.
Show
me
the video in the background. Well, I can you to pick.
Graphic.
Here, sign this release first, Bert.
Yeah.
Next, we have Morning Julia.
Good morning, Julia.
Good morning.
That day, Good Morning Julia realized they would be picking 8th in the bonfire draft.
Howard, are we turning you on to Sean Fury, or are you a Fury head?
You're turning me on to it.
Ooh. Well, let me tell you right now, that is a steep mountain you get to climb of pure entertainment.
One of my favorite names here, of course, for Chicago Dicks.
It's the sitcom of Sebastian Maniscalco and Dr. Phil McGraw.
Yep.
We created a fake radio serial.
Did you break into a dog dick dildo factory?
You gotta understand, I can psychology these criminals all the way back to a car
right in front of the bank you're gonna rob? Why would you do that?
This is my partner. He's from here. Me, I just understand how the human brain and heart works.
We keep it going.
And together.
Hold on. I just realized what you were doing. Yeah. I didn't know what you were doing for a second. And then I was like, oh, you're Dr. Phil. Yeah. Do it again.
That's what Chicago Dicks is. Two cops coming together just to clean up the worst city in the state.
We're not just partners. We're like family. He comes over. The wife makes the gravy. We sit down. We break bread.
I love when you do that Italian stuff. I have my dog, Maggie. She's a killing machine.
I go, oh, my God. That Maggie starts biting into people. I get, I can't even.
There's a whole radio serial that we promised, I think, 2 years ago and never delivered on. So, Team Chicago Dicks, you're drafting number 9.
And finally, picking last in the draft, but not least, the Aurora Airwolves, everybody.
Aurora Airwolves, I got to immediately get behind, repping A-Town and Airwolf. Jacob, I think we found our team. Aurora Airwolves.
I can't even.
Can I introduce you to my favorite thing I've ever done?
Yeah.
And that is doing comics acts, but without words. Just the noises they make when they do their act.
Dude, it's so fucking funny you do that because, you know, I live with Vecchione.
Yeah. Oh, my God. His fucking album is amazing.
You're going to be able to tell him about it. He's coming in. He's going to come in and do the second hour with us.
Oh, I cannot wait. Yeah. Wait. So, do Dave Attell, no words, Just noises.
He's here.
Well, that's the easiest one.
Okay, Dan Natterman.
Huh? Oh, Natterman.
Yeah.
Okay, do a good Natterman. He goes, hey.
You want a little Michelle Wolf?
Yeah.
I'm your Zanny.
Wait, do Ari.
Okay, hold on.
See, I would go more the long of the.
Guess who this is.
Howdy doody.
Ah! Is it Norman?
Yeah, I was trying to do Norman. That's almost Natterman, too.
Let's take our second break here. We got to let Howard go back. Again, it's nonstop fantasy football news, advice, and information to win your league. And you can catch that on Fantasy Alarm with Howard Bender and Jim Bowden. Weekdays, 4 to 6 p.m. Eastern, Sirius XM Fantasy Sports Radio, Sirius 210, XM87, streaming on your phone and at home on connected devices. Hear the show on demand by searching the Fantasy Alarm in the Sirius XM app. Howard, thank you so much for hanging out with us, buddy, and sitting through our nonsense. We are a disorganized bunch.
It was a pleasure, guys. Thanks for having
me. Man. We'll talk to you soon. Thank you, Howard. And we're hanging out with Bert Kreischer, The Machine.
New special, Secret Time, on Netflix.com.
We'll be right back, everybody. It's The Bonfire. Oh, drive fast, drive smart, drive hard. Make headlines in F1 2018, the official video game of Formula One that puts you behind the cockpit of your fastest racing machines in the world. Drive across 21 international circuits in the official 2018 season and overtake your rivals in the all-new revamped career mode where you can become the league's most respected or most notorious driver on the track. You could leverage your Formula One expertise in contract negotiations. This is where they get complicated, Dan, these games now. Well, now I think I'm aging out of this, but I know everyone that plays like the sports games moving forward loves all these,
like the features.
Like how involved it gets you. Yeah.
Yeah, well, you can like do contract negotiations to drive an F1 car. That's a lot.
You can upgrade the car through robust R&D systems, feel the pressure, and intense on-the-fly press interviews. This is the ultimate Formula One experience. It's available now on PlayStation 4 and Xbox One. Pick up your copy of F1 2018 today and make with me.
Ride the snake.
Hey, everyone, it's The Bonfire, Comedy Central Radio, Sirius XM 95. We're in the salacious hour.
Yeah, dude, it's getting
three jokers and Dan Soder, booze, Bert Kreischer.
We're telling secrets now.
Joining us.
Look, can I do the intro?
Please.
Ladies and gentlemen, my Eskimo brother, Mike Vecchione.
Hell yeah.
Thank you for having me on, guys.
Yeah.
Show fave.
Brand new album, The Worst Kind of Thoughtful, out now. Go download it. And also go watch Bert Kreischer's new hour special on Netflix.
Let me take it from here. Easily. I got a text from Chad Zumach who said, this is the best album I've heard since Attell's Skanks for the Memories, which is slander in my opinion.
Yeah.
Like, you can't say that to me because I literally wrote, fuck you.
That's your benchmark.
You're an idiot. I can't listen to you. And then I said, I'm listening to it right now. I listened to Part by Myself and then immediately was like, I texted you immediately. Yeah. I was like, this is one of the best albums I've ever heard. No joke. I've said that. I've tweeted it out about people that I'm friends with. I'm not joking. One of the best albums I've ever heard.
You started to tell us before you knew Mike was coming. We said you're going to be able to tell him in a few minutes. He's coming in. And he didn't know he was started talking
about it. My favorite thing I've ever done. Two moments in my life. I'm not even joking. Introducing my wife to Dave Attell.
Yeah.
I remember where I was. I was in my old house. I was in my Expedition, the old Ford Eddie Bauer Expedition.
Yeah, it was like tanks.
And it was a test to find out if I loved her or not. And I put it in on let's talk about, who's next, Dave? Eskimos? Oh, yeah, or as I call them, snow Mexicans.
Yeah.
I put that in and my wife laughed hysterically and I went, all right, I love her. I did the same thing for you on Megabus.
I swear to God,
we were pulling into Gelson's. I put in Megabus. I said, I need And the my line was, my line that I loved was, I kind of want to go to Baltimore, but I also want to see a dog fight. And my wife lost it. And I went, that's why I love you. And then we listened to it the whole ride to the party. And she was like, this guy's really fucking funny.
Yeah.
I said, and then I kept going, like, testing her. I was like, do you think he's like Attell, do you think? And she goes, no, not at all. Like, he's a joke writer. He definitely writes jokes, but, like, I don't hear Attell in him at all. I go, me neither. It's, like, totally separate. But I can tell all of our influences is Attell. Yeah, all of us. All of us.
Absolutely.
But, man, it's such a great fucking album. You should be very proud.
That meant a
proud.
Lot to me that you texted me, man. It really meant a lot.
Hell yeah.
And that you guys all posted it. Thank you very much.
Of course.
It made a huge difference.
Sorry, we don't have families to listen to them with.
Yeah.
Piece of shit.
Hey, Mike. You know, Mike, you know who I listen to my Mike Vecchione album with? You. When Mike you were Vecchione. Mastering it. In the other room, I'm like, if I hear that Megabus bit one more time, I'm going to shatter some fucking glass.
The worst kind of thoughtful is the album. It is out now. Make sure you pick it up, man.
Mike so I'm sitting between the woman who's coughing up blood and the guy performing minor foot surgery. Dude, it's a great fucking album, man.
Thank you, what's great about living with Mike is watching these unbelievable bits, like watch him build it, and then you feel like a lazy piece of shit because I need to write more. I gotta write more.
My whole act, I just did Conan last night, and I'm in the green room going, I wish Mike was here to punch mine up.
Yeah, dude. I mean, he'll come out and he'll be like, I wrote this joke, and then it's going into this one, and you go, fuck, all right, I'll put down the Madden.
Oh,
I wanted to bring up to you guys since Mike just released his album on a special. Bert has a special. This is a recipe. This sounds more like a recipe for what your comedy name should be.
Okay.
But they're saying this is the recipe. I saw this on Facebook today. See if you can find this, Christine. The recipe for naming your Netflix special. I always think these are fun and funny to do. And it is... Let me see here. Your special name recipe is your... I just wrote down... Netflix special name recipe and didn't write down exactly what it is. It's a
perfect.
The character you relate most to in the world.
Okay.
I guess from like movies or something. A character and then what was the other thing it was? This pod thing is really bad.
You know, sometimes
I did find other things that are good to talk about.
You know, by the way, I just looked through it and I realized that.
No, but this, can you find it at all, Christine?
You can buy potato chips on Amazon. I remembered that, and then I remembered everything was okay.
You mean potato chips?
Dude, you can buy potato chips on Amazon.
Netflix special formula, maybe. Look that up.
I say that because we like, what, like a potato chip that Jay introduced me to is Hers horseradish and cheddar.
Ooh, yeah.
Have you ever had it? Mm-mm. It's the greatest potato chip I've ever had in my life. And someone sent us bags of it from it. I think from Amazon, right?
I might take myself to a fancy dinner tonight.
Treat yourself, dude. You've been busting your ass. Where are you going to go?
I don't know.
Go to Peter Luger's. Just throw away some fucking money around. Let them know.
Go to Sparks Steakhouse. That's where Gotti killed Paul Castellano. It was a mob murder.
It's over on the east side.
Yeah.
Other bummer part about being around Vecchione, he likes to bring up mob murders a lot. It really is a real fucking rain cloud
on
your day.
Are you from Ohio originally?
Originally. I just drove from there today.
Youngstown.
You and Segura need to go on tour.
Yeah, I would like
to. What's your price point for Segura to take you on tour? Like, he's got a lot of money, but
I need very, very little money.
For real? Because I want to introduce you and Segura. I think Segura, you guys would be great.
I know him. We taped our half hours together. He's since skyrocketed.
Yeah,
and I put out one CD.
Fluke. You guys should do. You guys should do the Rust Belt tour.
Yeah,
the Rust Belt face. You guys both. I'm sorry. Was that mean?
Well, what was meaner is that you left the dishes in the sink. What if I just bring roommate issues into it? By the way, I guess you don't make your bed when I'm not at home.
Bring your weak-ass
make
shit.
Your bed?
We keep our doors open. It's part of the presentation.
I noticed my orange juice went away also.
Yeah, cool. Actually, someone did the dishes so you wouldn't come in here all fucking hot.
Because it ruins my process.
All right, goddamn.
Did you ever hear the speech from the Navy SEAL? He gives a commencement speech at a college about making your bed.
Mm-mm.
Okay, so it's like a very popular speech. This Navy SEAL feels I'm fucking hammered. Goes up and says, like, number one thing gonna make your bed. My wife gave me that speech. She had seen it online, and halfway through I go, did you just see this speech online? My wife was not unaware that a lot of people are online. She was like, maybe I heard it somewhere.
Whatever. It's like if someone tries to give you a quote and you're like, you heard that in a movie, and like, well, maybe. So what? Does it change the message? I don't think it does.
I wonder if anybody online or on Twitter knows what I'm talking about here. I wish I could remember the end of this goddamn thing. I've been looking it up while you guys are talking.
Dude, it's so great. You go, guys, I got a thing we're all about to do.
It would have been so good.
Ah, fuck. You know what? It turns out I didn't look into it.
I think you just look for the one bartender that didn't like your personality the most and name your special after her.
Yeah. Mine's called Alicia. Wait, so we never told the Eskimo Brothers story.
Dude, it's one of my favorite. It's one of my favorite stories
on the bonfire.
In life.
But I know it from, I mean, I just kind of, from both of you guys have told me.
It's separately. The girl I dated in high school and he dated in college.
Oh, wait a.
All right.
This is why he writes jokes and I tell stories.
I'm sorry. We got right.
Jesus Christ.
Dude, that's
did
so
I ruin it?
Shit. I fucking like wrote it for
Kennedy,
everybody.
Kennedy goes to Dallas and he gets shot. Yeah. He's done.
Mike. I can't fucking believe how different we are.
Wait, Jacob. Yeah, it was because they were both on the show, right?
Yeah, we might have.
So I think we addressed it that he was Mike the wrestler and he was Bert.
Oh my God! Can I just do it?
Yeah, just do it.
Please
show him how it's done.
My God!
Dude, I love Mike. Goes, hey Mike, what happened in Apollo 11? What happened in Apollo 13? He goes, they got launched. They almost died, and then they came back. Everyone was all right. He goes, that's it.
This is the definition of our different. The way we look at our art form.
Stylistically. 180 degrees difference.
Mike goes, get to the point and make him laugh, right? Boom. And I go, hey, man, we don't have a lot of material. Let's string it out.
You go like this. You go, it all started on a rainy day. Mike goes like this. And turns out the body's in the basement.
watch how I can. I call it Big J. Okay. I'm like, hey, man, I'm performing at the Mohegan Sun. Can you come and open for me? He goes, I got this buddy, Mike. Do you mind if he hosts? And I go, yeah, I don't care. He goes, he's funny as shit. So we go up. It was a horrible show. Do you remember how bad that show was?
Yeah, I remember.
A guy in a wheelchair with a straw.
For movement.
Walked out of my, when I was on stage. He walked out and heckled me in between breaths on his straw.
He's like,
it was that bad.
Stopped and then took another breath.
I was like, you suck.
You go like this. You go, I hope you catch a ramp that doesn't work as well as you think it's going to. He's like,
I had to watch him find the ramp. He had to like go across the thing. So,
yeah, the crowd was really. I remember not doing very well at all and being like kind of embarrassed about it. And you guys doing well?
No.
Jaded, well, you guys being able to do this.
Jaded crowd work and did fine. I did a tad bit of crowd work and then went into material and started bombing really bad and then blaming them for it. And then we get done and I had to drive home that night. I had to drive back to the airport. So we go back to Big J's room and we smoke a little bit of weed. Or I think maybe Jay and I did. Or maybe I had a couple beers. I don't remember.
Vecchione just did knuckle push-ups.
And so we're sitting there. But you know Vecchione, he's not a very like outgoing guy. He doesn't talk a ton. Yeah. He's not selling himself. He's not a self-promoter.
A real weirdo introvert. Sorry, Mike. All due respect.
I call it a water tower shooter vibe.
No disrespect is actually my podcast, which is on Gas Digital.
Self-promoter.
And Dan's podcast is Sleeps with One Eye Open. Yeah. You never know when this guy's going to go SEAL Team 6 on you.
Yeah, white knuckle soda.
Sleeps on his belly.
Yeah.
So I say to Mike, I go, hey, man, you're really funny. Where are you from? And Mike's like, I grew up in Ohio, but I went to school in Florida. I said, I'm from Florida. I love doing that. I'm from Florida.
Yeah.
And he goes, oh, yeah, I went to Boca. And I went, wait, are you serious? And he's like, yeah. And I said, I dated Miss Boca High. And he goes, haha, I dated Miss Boca High. And I went, wait, when did you graduate? And he goes, 91. And I went, Alex? And he goes, you're Bert from FSU. And I went, did you wrestle? I did. And I go, you're Mike the wrestler. So Mike and I almost got in a fist fight one night.
What?
I didn't realize
this
that.
This is why you stretch the story out, Mike.
That's what I love.
I forgot about this, but yeah. I didn't realize
it. In my mind, when you said that to him in the hotel, you go, are you Mike the wrestler? He just took off a t-shirt and it was a singlet under it.
And he went, yes. Put his mouth guard, his headgear, got on all fours. Go.
You found him.
Yeah. He goes, single leg takedown time.
So wait, there's this guy, Rocket.
Rashid. But he's one of my best friends. We wrestled together.
All right, Mike, you're not racist. We get it.
All right. Black Lou's not
nervous. This was pre-9/11.
All right, Mike.
We get it.
So Rocket went to Florida State, and he was cool. I knew him. He lived in like the rich people's dorms. And we were friends with him, and all the Boca kids knew him. So I go down to visit Alex. We had this guy that lived in Miami. Me and this guy, Jeff Hartley, go down. And Rocket's like, why don't you come by my house? We're having a party. So we went there, and I show up with Alex. Mike is standing behind like an island, a kitchen island.
Just arms full.
Nope. sleeveless shirt.
Right? Yeah! Yes. Shirts ablaze.
It was hot.
I would argue.
Under Armour tights under basketball shorts.
Yeah. Oh, no, it was way before that. I would argue a flat top.
Yeah.
Hell yeah.
Arms posted up like this. And just staring at us. Yeah. And Rocket's right next to him.
I saw a picture on that in Mike's parents' house. Yeah. I saw a picture of that exact pose you're talking about.
Yeah. That's what we call the power V in the Vecchio family.
And my buddy Jeff just they're both similar energies.
Yeah.
He dials in on Mike like, oh, what's this? Oh, posturing, huh? Whatever. And they start, literally, Mike is not backing down.
Yeah.
And all I can remember is Alex was like, he's a really good wrestler. Yeah. I don't want to get on the ground with anybody.
I don't want to fucking take this to the mat.
All I remember doing is talking shit and then turning around and running out to the car. Talking shit. Like, go, 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 go.
San Dimas High School football sucks. Yeah. Bye.
Fuck you. The Boca Mustangs blow. Go, 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 go. Get to the car. That's fucking hilarious because it's just funny that I know Mike and just seeing him being like, well, there she is coming in with fucking her new boyfriend from Florida State. Fucking Alex is being disrespectful coming to Rocket's house like this.
What was your team name? The Boca...
Bobcats.
The Wildcats?
Not Wildcats. The Boca Raton.
The Boca High Houseboats. Yeah. Or,
the Shuffleboards.
The Socks and Sandals.
The Boca Raton Divorcees.
The Boca Old Jews.
The Boca Raton Turquoise Jewelries.
Yeah.
It's so funny now to have met him and know his personality. Listen to his
That would have been great if you would have just pushed me back then when we were doing the casino. And be like, oh. You talk now? You open for me. You fucking just open for me. Yeah. Get down on your knees.
Oh. Hey, big mouth. Who's being a big mouth now?
He goes, here's what I do. I don't fight you at house parties. I get into the same business you do. Then I get farther than you.
Then I
make you fucking open for me. So what's up, motherfucker? You spilled my drink.
How much the club pay you? Yeah. Ooh, I'm going to pad your money a little bit. Look at that. Break you up a couple more hundo.
You open your calendar. I'm going to get you some more dates.
I'm open up some more dates for you.
You know what? Are you in at the Improv in L.A.? Well, why don't you fucking come out there, and I'll walk you over to the Booker.
Oh, Denver Comedy. You've never been to Denver Comedy? Oh, well, they should see you. Wendy would fucking love you, Mr. Big Man.
Fuck. Oh, fuck. Do you want to start a podcast? What the fuck? What the fuck?
Dude, I'll be honest with you. My sister's single, and I'll be honest. You seem like the kind of guy that would really treat her right.
Oh, my God.
How about that, motherfucker?
Oh, my God. What's your suit size? Are you a 46? I got a fucking sports coat with your name on. Oh, fuck, I remember you.
Oh, man. Dude, I want a vacation with you. But like you and like everybody.
Fuck.
Together, man.
God damn, would you be down with playing touch football in the park with me and some buddies?
I'm trying to start up a fucking adult kickball league, man. But I swear to God, I wish you would be there.
I want
to
operate outside of Zog because I feel like they run shit and they take money for the fees that don't go to any good. Yeah, that's fucking crazy that you guys.
He could have legitimately done that, though.
I mean, that would have been some Count of Monte Cristo shit, but I'm saying you, like, being in the same business randomly after being outside of the business, it happened to me in Tucson. I worked at Outback. When I came back from Alaska, I blew all my money. Like, I blew all my money within 3 months, and I was dead broke, and I was like, I need a job, and I went to Outback trying to be a waiter, and they're like, I was 19, and they're like, yeah, you can't be a waiter, but we can hire you as a busboy. Then when a waiter job opens, you'll be
boys are back in town.
Yeah. And so I fucking go to Outback, and this 15-year-old kid trains me. And I'm like, dude, I bus tables since I was like 13. You don't need to train me. And the guy's like, no, you need to do 3 shifts on the floor. It's company policy. And so this 15-year-old's like, and this is how you bus? And his brother was like the head server, this guy Rudy, and he was a fucking prick. He was just a prick to me. He was just mean the whole time. All 3 training shifts was just like a dick. He's like, my little brother's training. And I was like 19 and still kind of a psycho. So I was just kind of like, I'll fucking kill Rudy. Like, I drive home punching the steering wheel. Like, oh yeah. And then Rudy's all like, bah, bah, bah. So finally, I get hired at KFMA. Shout out KFMA Day. At a radio station to be a DJ. So I quit Outback. And I start working at the radio station, start stand up. Year later, I'm doing an open mic. And I see on the sign-up sheet, it says Rudy something or whatever. And I was like, nah. And I look over, and it was fucking Rudy. It was the kid from Outback that was like a dick to me. And I was like, hey, put me on before him. because I'd already like started emceeing and shit and like, you know, work, like doing comedy. Yeah. I was like, put me on before him. And I just fucking went up and just at an open mic did all the jokes that work and just leaned into them and then watched him bomb. And it was one of the most gratifying things that's ever happened in my life.
Dude, there's a guy named, I'm going to fuck this up and I apologize, Christian Harland, I think. Oh, fuck. I wish I'd knew this better.
Yeah.
But like my very first time doing stand-up ever, it's like four guys who had done stand-up and then me.
Yeah.
And this guy, and I grab a beer, and I go to take a sip, and this guy comes up to me. I don't know the guy at all.
Yeah.
And he goes, hey, man, nothing for nothing, that's a really bad habit to start. And I went, really? And he goes, yeah, if you need a drink to get on stage, then for the rest of your career, you'll need a drink to get on stage. So don't do it. Don't do it. So I didn't drink. I didn't drink. I went on stage sober. And to this day, I'd rather be on stage sober than drunk. I'd hate being on stage with a buzz. Christian Harland, I think is his name. I've talked about him a number of times.
Yeah, and he told you. He was like, don't.
Dude, and he hit me up. He's out. He's in L.A. He's got a podcast called Schmoes Knows, I think. And he's like a store guy. He was a store guy for a while and then kind of like went off to do his own thing.
Yeah.
But like to run into that guy again and be like, hey, man, you might have saved my life.
Yeah, by saying
the best
that.
Advice you've ever given me in my entire fucking life.
I like mine was just vindictive, and I was like, fuck Rudy. He's a cunt. And then Bert's like, this guy's actually a good dude and kind of saved me from a life of misery.
How crazy is it that this one girl that Mike and I both dated,
yeah,
who, by the way, was way more artistic than either of us.
Yeah. She was an actress. I remember that. She was hardcore. In theater. Hardcore,
she still is. Google her. Pull her up.
She's a pig. She can't be trusted.
No, she's beautiful. God, I guarantee you,
if really we pull up pretty, a picture man. Of her, she really had her shit she's together. Beautiful. Like,
well, here's the real point. It's the character you most relate to and the last thing you ate.
I fucking love it. I love it. Oh, dude.
Got
I like
it.
That you were in the
earlier
the
today, time. My Netflix special would have been called Angus Turkey Chili.
Mine would be called Woody Burrito.
Woody?
Yeah.
Toy Story Woody?
Yeah.
That's the character you most relate to?
Yeah.
Woody Burrito?
Yeah.
I like it.
Carl Oysters.
That sounds like a mob name.
And Carl from what? What's Carl? What's the character?
Scotty Chuck.
Okay.
Rocky Cheesesteak.
Rocky Cheesesteak.
Yeah.
I mean, that sounds like a
you most relate to Rocky?
I love Rocky.
How do you see
Rocky.
Yourself?
I love Rocky.
But that's how you most Rocky. Relate yourself
I don't know,
to
relate.
Rocky?
I love Rocky.
That's not what it is.
What's
the
relate?
Character you most relate to?
I love the chips are all against Rocky, man.
The chips aren't against you, Mike.
Yes,
you're
they
fine.
Are. No, I'm not fine.
You don't live
Jay.
In a fucking. Oh, you do
Let's
live with
Let's go to my dates. Let's go to my dates. We'll see if I'm fine.
Hey, he's my Buzz Lightyear.
Yeah, dude, it should be fucking Buzz Kale chips or something.
Buzz Kale chips.
Buzz Ants on the log.
I never even saw that movie.
All right. Yeah, because you don't allow joy in your life.
You're not allowed to. You were doing singing doo-wop outside of a garbage fire.
Yeah. You were fucking fighting in sweaty gym shorts.
Take me back. Doo-doo-doo-doo. Take me back.
Yeah, you
Rocky were... Cheesesteak.
Yeah, why did my choice
Rocky
get a...
Rocky Cheesesteak should
Why
be
did you guys attack my choice?
Because you called yourself Rocky.
I didn't call myself Rocky, Jay. I relate to Rocky.
You also
why?
Called...
I lived in Philadelphia. I'm an Italian. What, do I have to draw all the parallels
yeah,
for you guys?
You guys called yourself fucking...
Okay, no, let's all change ours based on Mike's rules. Okay, mine's Iron Man Steak.
Okay, cool.
I'm not saying I'm a heavyweight champion.
Wait, oh, I'm sorry. I have to wait for you. My name is Terminator Nachos Belgrande.
Dude, I totally get that. I'm actually Rambo's Grandma Slice.
Oh, I understand now. I'm sorry. I'm Predator Jack in the Box.
Yeah. Oh, that's pretty awesome.
Oh, Predator Cheese Fries.
Yeah. I'm Halloween Steak. That just doesn't even make sense.
Actually, technically today, I'm Angus Munchkins.
Yeah. Oh, dude, Angus Munchkins is a fucking badass rhythm guitarist.
Angus Munchkins? Oh, that guy shreds.
Yeah, dude, you put Angus Munchkins in a session. Munchkins.
Let's take our last break here so we can come back and ride this bitch out to the very end.
And we need
everybody.
Ice. We probably need ice.
Wait, do I? If that,
and we probably get some ice.
If you're Rocky, who am I? Paulie?
Oh, dude, you're most. It's who you most relate
no, you're
to.
Adrian.
Well, thank you. That's all I wanted.
Oh, my name's sorry.
Take me to the zoo. Yeah. Retards love the zoo.
I'm Cal.
You're that guy. You're the driver.
Oh, have you guys heard my new Netflix special, Cal-El Sugar Smacks?
Cal-El Sugar Smacks!
We'll be right back. It's the Bonfire. Hanging out with Bert Kreischer and Mike Vecchione. We'll be right back. Bonfire. 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 That's a fucking awesome name.
Altoona.
I mean, I know we're like trying to have fun right now, and we're all laughing about
it. That's a pretty dope name for a special.
But can I tell you right now, you just blew my fucking mind. His real name's Big Jerickerson. Hi, this is The Bonfire on Comedy Central Radio, Sirius XM 95. I'm Dan Soder. That's Big Jerickerson, who's going to be in Rhode Island at the Comedy Connection August 30th through September 1st, and then at Laugh Boston on September 8th with Louis J. Gomez and Dave Smith for two live tapings of Legion of Skanks, 4 p.m. and 11:30 p.m. Go get tickets at BigJComedy.com. One of our guests has a brand new Netflix special out on Netflix.com or wherever you stream Netflix. Secret Time, It's the Machine, Bert Kreischer.
Yes.
Hey-o.
And our other guest is my common-law husband, 7 years strong. Love this man. Know all of his weaknesses. His new album, not one of them.
When he got out of jail, he needed a place to stay, and he found Dan, and they fell in love.
I rehabilitated him into the machine that he is today. The worst kind of thoughtful, go download it now wherever, like iTunes.
Let's not forget, not only is Bert's special out, yeah. Mike's album out, but also Dan Soder has some shit going on. He's going to be at the Brokerage in Long Island, New York, August 31st and September 1st. And after that, he's going to be at the Vault at Valley Forge Casino. Ooh, getting fucking historical. What?
Sorry, guys. I like to work historical venues.
Oh, you can get a hand job in fucking George Washington's old bunker.
I would love to.
Oh, by the way, I'm here for the New York Comedy Festival.
Hell yeah.
Fuck yeah. November?
November, and then I'm doing like some other stuff.
Do the comedy jam with me, dude.
Okay.
Hell yeah.
Can I tell you what I want to do?
Mm-hmm.
Well, go ahead. I got a zillion ideas.
I'll tell you right now. It's Notorious B.I.G. and Miley Cyrus. Pull it up. Party in the USA.
Party and Bullshit in the USA.
Party and Bullshit in the USA. I want to do that song for my goal.
Yeah.
It's the fucking best song.
Ugh. Yeah?
Yeah. Oxnard this weekend. Lots of tickets left.
Oxnard. Go get tickets.
I mean, like, a legit.
Party.
Really?
And Bullshit.
Like maybe 2,000 tickets left.
How big is the theater?
Oh, it's no. It's the club. Man, I have literally legit sold no tickets in Oxnard.
So
where's Oxnard?
California. Oh,
baby. It's where the boxers train. I think.
Yes.
It's where the fighters
train. Where the party at? And can I bring my cat?
Go get more question tickets.
Wouldn't this be great on... I don't know what I'm going to do with the N-word in here, but I think if you sing it, it seems more friendly.
I say own it. Black Lou says own it.
It says lean
Make
in.
Make it yours. Actually, Black Lou suggested wearing blackface, but with white mouth, like Al Jolson.
Yeah!
His shirt's off.
Fuck it, hey! You know what song I want Jay to do at Goddamn Comedy Jam?
What?
Is I want him to do Dead Man's Party.
Boingo, I'll do boingo. It.
No.
It's a Dead Man's Party.
Pull that up and I will drink hard.
Yeah. Right.
What? Dead Man's Party?
Dude, I used to shower listening to that song.
Crank it right now.
Boingo. With my sister's pink ghetto box.
Yeah. Hell yeah.
Ghetto box. How racist is that?
This is something actually you guys missed before or when we were talking earlier today. That's going to be tomorrow, right? It's not tomorrow. It's going to be on the Lost Tapes.
Yeah, the Roadhouse?
The Teen Wolf. In the 80s, you just walk up dancing.
Yeah.
Turn it up. I know all the words.
Let's see.
I'm just a man doing it.
Bert's going to get hit.
You know, he's married to Jenna Elfman.
Yeah. Danny Elfman.
I know Danny Elfman, but he's every Tim Burton movie ever. He's Simpsons. Oingo Boingo's lead singer and guitarist is a gazillionaire off of scoring films. Everything Tim Burton's always
Danny
been Danny
Elfman, right?
Wow. Yeah.
I bet this is, what's the guy's name? Is Aquaman? Not Aquaman. Iron Man?
Oh, Robert Downey Jr.
I bet you play this to him and he's like, oh, I kind of want to get high.
Yeah. Oh, fuck yeah.
Turn it up, Lou.
What version is this?
Is it when it kicks in? Let us feel it in our hearts.
Hey! Downey's gonna do more blow.
Hey!
No, I don't get angry. He goes, I get upset. And Lou over there, he gets angry.
Hey, Dean Martin. Yeah, the triple Lindy.
I thought it was Pauly, by the way.
Yeah, it was Pauly. Turns out Iron Man's got a little bit of a problem with the blow.
Turn it up, Lou. Stop treating us like old men. I'll comedy jam this.
Hell yeah.
I got that 80s voice there.
So the seal?
Walking down the street. I was struck by something that
sounded. It sounds like you're doing John Travolta doing a Ringo Boy,
though. It's a dead man's party.
Who could ask for more?
Yeah.
Everybody's coming. Leave your body turn up at the door. Leave your body at the door.
This is the part you gotta hit.
Don't run away. It's only me.
Nailed it.
I'm going to start doing blow if you do this song.
It's always every 80s right. voice was every right. 80s voice was that. It goes, hit, I know play, this play, much
video killed the radio star.
True.
Video killed the radio star.
And then, can I have a request? Whip it after that.
Mike's in Devo.
Can I
have Whip It?
Can I do Opposites Attract? Paula Abdul?
By the way, I can definitely do this show for 24 hours.
MC Scat Cat?
Why can't you? Why are you going to be such a dick when it's my thing?
He turned on me with Rocky. Oh. Did you see the way he turned on me?
He called himself Rocky.
I did not call myself Mike. Rocky, Jack. Oh,
I'm John Holmes.
Yeah. Oh, I like to be, yeah. I'm Dirk Caesar Dirk Salad.
Dirk Caesar Salad. By the way, that's the joke I meant to say.
Yeah. Oh, man, I'm fucking.
Oh, my name is Chuck Norris Mozzarella Sticks.
Oh, yeah. Me, I'm Delta Force Chicken Parm.
I take it back. Steven Seagal.
Yeah.
Are you talking about?
Steven Seagal is my
I'm
guy.
Jean-Claude. Oh.
Are you talking about Steven from the Kumite?
Yeah.
I'm SEALs Team 6 M&Ms.
I'm taking Pad Thai. Yeah. I wish I had a Casio just to nail it, that part.
Why isn't this stuff more popular? These are good songs.
Oh, yeah, dude. I know.
Video killed the radio star.
I mean, I think we're finding out.
They won't let me.
Why?
They won't let me DJ an 80s station here for an hour.
They won't?
They say I gotta pre-record it. Me and Christina had this conversation this weekend. She goes, well, you can go and do the 80s station or the Yacht Rock station.
That's awesome.
And pre-record an hour. I go, no, the whole thing to me of DJing is I want to do it live. I want to sit there and listen to the songs for an hour.
Can I tell you what I did? I did a straight-up reel. I'll send it to you. And you guys
in the post?
I did a reel of me playing music drunk as fuck in my man cave for SiriusXM, and I did an hour of me listening to music and then cutting off it, drunk as fuck, being like, this is what I'm fucking talking about.
I love
you're not feeling this fucking music.
Love
this is what, I don't even want to fucking meet you. Yeah. All right, next song. Here we go. Like,
hey, you're listening to the bird here in the man cave. Wait, no, got some chickens running around. Got some kids running around.
It's Blackout Radio on SiriusXM. Bert's hammered.
Yeah, I'll send it to you. I'll send it to you.
BLKT Radio. WBLKT Blackout Radio.
And don't forget about the extra show yelling at the neighbors.
Wait, put on.
You're going to hear four Jethro Tull songs you've never heard because you nodded off on Aqualung.
He's asleep on the couch.
High kicks, tight pants. High kicks, tight pants. This is the song me and my daughters are obsessed with.
Okay.
Now, I was high when they played it for the first time. We were camping. Oh my God, it's the top one. Tight pants, body rolls. Tight pants, body rolls.
Okay.
I'm obsessed with this song.
She's dressed like Bruce Leroy.
Oh, I've seen this.
Have you seen it?
Yeah.
I was walking through the forest of moccasin bread when I saw.
She's dressed like Bruce Lee in Chinese Connection.
Yeah. Oh yeah, entirely. I want
to own. Where is this? I know this chick from. Can you even dance
in those pants? Watch me, woman.
They made a move like a vessel of shimmy, tall, sweet and tender like a tiny baby kitty. I need to get some, put my body in them, then I will rule the world.
See, this is what I'd do if I had my own radio show. I play this and Michael in the bathroom.
I want to DJ an hour or two so bad, but they won't let me. They literally won't let me here.
Why
not?
They want it to be pre-recorded.
Yeah.
They want
me to just like record like intros and outros to songs.
Listen to the whole song.
Huh?
So you can't pre-record.
Because there's something about it listening live. You're listening live and I'm telling you why this next song is the shit.
Right.
And listen to it. And then I play, you know, whatever, fucking Africa by Toto. And
all right,
then you're
here's
like,
where we go. Here's this game.
Yeah.
Ready? Mm-hmm. I can start with me if we need to. Hit the post on your song you want to intro.
We've done this on the show before. We've had a blast with it.
Oh, for real?
No, okay. We did this with you.
Oh, I think
we took turns trying to hit the post.
Yeah.
I'll do it every time. I love
it. But pick the song in your head that you want to hear where you hit the post, and then you go, And then you give your intro of your own late night Sirius XM. Place is closed. It's 2 a.m.
If,
and it's your
if there's no way
oh,
that
I get my dick sucked by a girl with got a gold tooth.
This is
legit.
This is
you guys are talking to a guy that used to do overnights in Tucson.
Yeah, Dan did
there's
this.
Nothing to do when you're working.
He used to get sucked off for Dawkins CDs.
Yeah, dude. I straight up traded a classic rock album to get a blowjob. Yeah, from this chick named Dawn.
Dawn.
at an AutoZone loading bay.
Fuck yeah, it was.
This is our pitch to SiriusXM.
Yeah, dude.
We each want our late night show.
Let me tell you, here, dude. Smashing Pumpkins today,
you know,
and I'll do it. I'll do it like I'll try to hit the post like I'm about to get out of here to go get blown in a Dodge Stratus.
I swear to you, I would come in at 2-3 o'clock in the morning to do an hour or two of radio,
and just
to play music I want to hear and sit and like smoke,
yeah,
hit a vape pen or something and just sit here until. I mean, it would. I would love it.
I'll drink again.
And know that people are listening.
Would you get facts about the, or just tell your own emotional stories about the songs?
Maybe just tell my own emotional. Just tell you why I'm picking it. This song's great. Hey, everyone. The breakup song by Greg Kinn. Suck in my dick if you don't like it. You're an idiot.
Why don't we talk to Jacob? Why doesn't Jacob, can you do this? Could you actually make this happen?
No.
No, we can't make it.
No, they can't.
Why not?
Because they don't want live radio at SiriusXM. I don't understand it at all.
But this is live radio. No one tunes into
It's crazy.
Serious for, like, the live part is what's fun about it.
Yeah, we're live.
They told me we can do Yacht Rock. Dan could do. You were doing the '90s thing.
Yeah,
but they've offered us all this stuff, but they keep saying we have to come in and just go. Oh, everyone, this is a great song. Come on, you know this one from the '80s. Everyone is Toto with Africa.
Yeah, you got to.
And
hear
then they go, okay. Wait, like 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay, now it goes. Everyone, that was Africa by Toto. How cool! And,
like, all right, I'm doing that next week. I'm doing that next week.
I don't want to do it.
I'm gonna ask if I can do straight and listen to music and drink
live. They're going to say no.
Will you come in with me,
buddy? They will not let you do it. I've tried this for months and months. Yeah, a year we've been going for this.
I'm in. I'm doing it. I'm making it happen.
If you could turn it around,
Rubber Band Man. Start with Rubber Band Man.
I'll come in with you.
It's all of us in here, right?
Yeah.
We're all partying.
Yeah.
Rubber Band Man. Do we have it coming up?
Dude, I love Christine was like, but that was on me? What's up?
What's up, Rubber Band Man?
She goes, I thought you were calling me Rubber Band Man. Is that not what you're calling me? Is that not my new name?
Well, you know, I like Captain Lou Albano.
Here we go. Ready? We're all drinking. We're having a good time. I don't know. No, this is T.I.'s Rubber Band Man.
This is wrong.
A little bit different than this has been. Oh, here we go. All right, guys, we're drinking. It's 2 a.m. Dan, it's good to see you, man.
Good to see you, Bert.
Jay?
Great to be here.
This weed is strong. Mike, what do you think in your name, if you're a movie star, what would your name be?
I'm going to stay with what do you mean?
Rocky Cheesecake! If he's driving a spaceship through the world, it's Rocky Cheesecake! I'm looking at Alf Bologna Sticks!
Alf Bolognese
is the man.
I just want you guys to know that we're not going anywhere. We're going to be here all night. I love you with all my heart. My name is Bert Kreischer. My special is called Secret Time on Netflix. That's fucking great.
That's good.
All right, do another one.
That wasn't bad at all.
This is our pitch to SiriusXM.
Lou, do you have it?
You got a good one? Yeah, Dan, you have one queued up? I'll do one.
Yeah.
I got that.
You got mine?
Yeah, you
ready?
Yeah. It's got to be free-flowing, drunk and loose.
It's Dan, Bert, Jay, and Mike hanging out. Goddamn that. This is way faster than it used to be when I worked at KFMA. It used to be 25-second intro.
No, but it doesn't matter, but you still get... That's not the post yet.
That's kind of the main post. You're going to be like, KFMA. If you can hit that, was like a fun one to hit.
Really?
Let me try to hit it real quick.
That's too short.
Yeah, I know.
A lot longer,
ready? Right. Here we go. I'll hit it quick. Hey, my name is Mark Reiser. My show is Secret Time on Netflix. Here we go. Please.
Well, I'm going to try to do it. That's a running downhill intro,
right?
Yeah. Fuck, I hope you're having a good time. It's Dan Soder. It's Smash Buckets. Yeah, that used to be 25 seconds. Am I wrong?
Yeah. Wouldn't that shit?
Yo, man, I worked in radio for fucking a long time, and that used to be the one that you were like, you really suck your own dick trying to hit the post, where you'd be like, don't forget KFMA.com, still some things. You're like, me.
Give me Rosanna by Toto.
Oh.
Ooh, I like this.
Oh.
I sound like Dave Chappelle with his deep voice.
Cheers, voice change.
Yep. Oh, you know what that sound is, everybody. You remember. Desperately seeking Susan all the way to Pulp Fiction. She was hot until she was not, everybody. Oh, I blew it.
You got to make it. You got to make it. Yeah. You got to make it inclusive.
I didn't get. Yeah,
with all of us. Like, you know what I like? We're hanging out drinking. This is our pitch to Sirius XM.
You know what I like though is that you're like, all right, and you like went into a long story. It. You're like, and then she.
I thought
got
I had to go a little bit. I had for some reason I had a little bit longer in my head.
Dude, make it. Be in the moment. Be in the moment. A little buzz. A little bit of like, this is what we do, guys. It's late night. It's 2 a.m. You're in your truck.
What's my song? I'm thinking. What's my song?
Sister Christian.
Oh, okay. I was gonna. That's too that's epic. How about Rock the Cradle of Love, Billy Idol?
Oh, okay. No.
Okay.
Can I just?
Sure.
It should be a song that inspires you to drink. Like for me, it's the Smiths. It's something like a little like out there. Like,
well, then I'm gonna say one bourbon, one scotch, one beer. George Thorogood.
Let's do it. Okay, hang on. I'm going to raise my hand, and when I drop my hand, start playing it, okay? Because part of this fun is we're fucking around. Sure. We're having a good time, okay? Yeah. Oh, dude, and that's the last time I ever was naked in bed with three guys.
I just wanted to sit in there for a little bit.
He's ready now. Go ahead.
All right. So, and then I got on the horse, and I was like, apparently I don't have control of this horse. Fuck!
Jesus, Lou. What happened? No, what's the...
It's with a slow fade.
It's one bourbon, one scotch, one beer.
That's it.
Oh, wait, what's the... I drink alone. I'm thinking I drink alone is what I meant. I'm sorry.
Right, when my hand goes
it's
up,
better,
start
yeah.
it, okay?
Ready,
okay? So I grab her by both ears. I'm like, fuck it. I'll just rip both her ears off. Who cares? I don't know.
Oh! Bert Kreischer keeps the stories coming, and Dan keeps the drummers drumming. We got Rocky Cheesesteaks hanging out all night with us, everybody. We're partying here at Sirius XM, Untucked Radio, UNTK, the Beat of New York. The Machine, the Voice, the Chest, and me, I'm the Tits. We're here, everybody.
Yeah, I like that. I think that sells the show.
I think we did it.
I think they're going to give us 5 hours of live radio.
Can you explain at all why? Because Christine, every time she brings it up to me again about coming in and recording intros and outros, I scoff and get completely furious at it and don't understand the reason why a radio... force that is Sirius XM doesn't want anybody playing live music, like playing it on the what's the point of that?
I don't know. I mean, I'm not part of the music.
We're doing it for free. Christine, what do they say? What's their problem?
You do the whole
hour clean.
You do the whole hour clean.
It's music.
No, but it's
80s. Now you're probably not. Can they just XL it for an hour?
No, absolutely not.
No,
you guys
I know.
Would it's going to be playing Bonfire. In the doctor's office. You have to be.
No, listen. I understand. Listen, we could absolutely. Of course, we could do it clean.
We could do it clean.
Of course.
You mean not cursing?
Yeah, it's fine.
Oh, the music plays in doctor's offices.
Well, it can.
Yeah, they have to be able to say.
But I'm also asking. Can we do it? Why can't we do it 2 to 4 in the morning? Just playing music and chilling out and smoking and drinking. Why?
Can you give me Steve Winwood back in the high life again?
Well, I like this.
You might be able to change it for a different channel, like if it's Ozzy's Boneyard.
Well, dude, we're doing 80s.
We want 80s music.
We want to do 80s on 8. So I go, hey, what's going on? It's Dan Soder, Bert Kreischer, Mike Vecchione, and Big J. You're getting your wisdom teeth pulled. Well, right now, we've got enough sedatives to make us all feel like we are. Avoid dry socket and enjoy eating soup for the next 3 weeks. And remember, you'll be back in the high life in no time. Here's some Steve Winwood on Untucked.
Strawberry Hills. Hit me with Strawberry Hills. Send me with Strawberry Hills. See if I can do it. I don't know. I haven't listened to this song in forever.
Peter Gabriel?
You're right. Isn't that what you just played?
Yeah.
Strawberry Hill.
Blueberry.
Salisbury Hill.
Strawberry Hill. I'm like, that sounds fucking cool.
Salisbury
Hill. I think that's my wife's tits.
Strawberry Hills.
And red nipples. Secret night.
You got it? Ladies and gentlemen, we got it.
It's so good to have you guys back. I'm sitting with Jay Soder and Dan Bergen. I'm fucked up.
Can I do Quiet Riot? Come on, bang your head.
That's
the best one for sure.
Yeah, do it, Mikey. Do it,
come
Rocky
on,
Cheesesteak.
I'm not a radio guy. I'm not
I know.
This.
Come
my
on,
first
Rocky
try.
Cheesesteak.
Just raise your hands in the air.
Welcome to the show, everybody. I'm hanging here with Dan, Bert, and Jay Oakerson. We're getting ready to skull fuck your sister on a Friday night.
Dude.
I love this song for me is particularly, we used to drive, me and Lewis and Dave, when we were driving to gigs in Montreal, when they would headline me at the Comedy Works up there, Jimbo's.
Yeah.
And we used to take these long drives, and we would do 2 hours of the ride, restarting that song over and over again, and say it's the best way to do shit intros for comics, you know?
Yeah, that's funny.
We go, he's a... Do you have the song ready?
Yes.
Let me. When I point to you, kick it in, okay? Yeah. When I point to you.
Yeah. Yeah.
He's a rabbi, he's a comic, he's neither, he's from Brooklyn, New York! Modi! Yeah! 3 hours.
Let me do me, okay? Ready, here we go.
I'll point to you when to do it.
I'll point.
Because you have to, it's your intro, and then he's, and yeah, then yep, that yep, yep,
yep, yep. I think I know how we're gonna do it. Ladies and gentlemen, he's a father, he's a husband, he's a hesitant passenger, he's a machine! Oh, shit.
I gotta do me now.
I wish I could jack off again today.
I have that reoccurring thought quite often, too, Bert. I have it a lot. He's a giant head. He's a ton of voices from the shadows of the Rocky Mountains. He's Dan Soder. This is awesome.
I'll do my own.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
If you like dirty jokes that you've thought of, you've probably already heard this nonsense. Make some noise for Philly's own Big Jokerson!
What a fun episode.
Do one last. You got one?
No? Anyone got one?
Do five more.
Do 20 more. Do an hour more.
I've had a blast. I'll be back tomorrow.
What do you think Comedy Central is going to pull us out of the studio? Fight me. Come back tomorrow?
Yeah.
You coming back on? 6 o'clock? Vecchione, what are you doing tomorrow?
We got Vecchione coming back tomorrow.
Yeah, I can come back.
All right, why don't you come back?
Oh, I'm going to tell you what we have here. That's fine. By the way, who gives a shit? Way fun. Come in tomorrow. Because it's 7 p.m. tomorrow, we have Everlast coming in studio.
Oh, fuck yeah, my God, dude.
That's going to be awesome.
Guitar?
Yeah. I'm going to make him.
You play guitar?
Yes.
Oh, fuck yeah, dude. Yeah. Hell yeah.
Dude, him playing.
Can we all take turns doing his voice?
Can I do Everlast? Can Everlast do a song about Mike and I living together? He goes, Dan's in the living room playing PlayStation. Mike's in the bedroom working out.
Two guys standing around a Nutribullet wishing they was in love.
That brings us together. What a fucking fun episode of the Bonfire.
You heard it here. Bert Kreischer, Mike Vecchione, coming in tomorrow.
And now, right now, go watch their special. Go watch Bert's special, Secret Time, on Netflix. Go download Mike's album, The Worst Kind of Thoughtful, on iTunes. Go to BigJComedy.com and pick up tickets if you're in the Boston area.
Where are you this weekend, Dan?
I'm in Long Island.
You're in Long Island. I'm in Rhode Island, everybody. Get your tickets. You know, BigJComedy.com, DanSoder.com. We'll all be back tomorrow, so we'll see you in 12 hours, everybody.
We might just stay here. We might just sleep over.
We're not 20 to 12. We'll see you in 20 hours, everyone. 22 hours.
22. 21 and a half.
12 hours.
12 hours.
2 to 5.
Where are we?
I don't know.
Who are you?
Who am I?
Are you my son?
I'll tell you exactly who the fuck I am. I'm Braddock McPickles.